The topic is evaluating the double integrals by converting to polar coordinates. So let's do this example. Evaluate the double integral where because of a dx, so I know this is x, so x goes from 0 to 2, and because the inner integral is with respect to y, so I know this is y and this is y, so the y goes from negative square root of 4 minus x squared to 0. So how do I sketch my region? I know the x goes from 0 to 2, but the y goes from, y equals negative square root of 4 minus x squared. If you square both sides, you get y squared equal 4 minus x squared, which is a circle, x squared plus y squared equal 4. However, if you solve for y, you get minus or plus square root of 4 minus x squared. So we need the negative 1, meaning the bottom half circle. So, but, well, let me draw all of it, even though we're not going to use all of it. But we want the x to go only, so this is y equal minus square root of 4 minus x squared. This is right here, y equals 0. So we need this region, right? So this is our d. So let's do it now. Let's call this 1. So my integral will be equal. The theta is going to go from negative pi over 2 to 0. Right? The radius is going to go from here to here. It's the same radius, so it's going from 0 to 2. Right? And then we have x is r cosine theta. It's right here. And the y squared, y is r sine theta, so that would be r squared sine squared theta. And don't forget these r dr d theta, so r dr d theta. Now this is going to be equal integral from negative pi over 2 to 0, 0 to 2. So r times r squared, it's r cubed times this r is r4. So it's r4 sine squared of theta cosine theta dr d theta. So we're going to start with the inner integral. So it's going from negative pi over 2 to 0. We're taking the integral with respect to r. So this is a constant we don't touch. So that would be r5 over 5. Sine square theta cosine theta, and this is between r equals 0 to 2 d theta. Now plug in the 2 for r, that would be 2 to the fifth, which is 32 over 5 sine square theta cosine theta minus 0, which is just a 0. So this is d theta. Right? Now again, I'm going to call my u. Let me show you here. So I'm going to call my u to be sine theta. So therefore, du will be just cosine of theta d theta. So this is du, all the way here. And this is the u. I mean, this is like u squared. So the answer will be u3 over 3. So meaning sine cube of theta over 3. Don't forget 32 over 5. And you want that between outside. You want that between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. So this is going to be equal 32. I'm going to take the 3 outside. 32 over 15. And then that would be sine of pi over 2 cube minus sine over negative pi over 2 cubed. That would be equal to 32 over 15. Sine of pi over 2 is 1, so that would be 1. And sine of negative pi over 2 would be minus 1, so 1 minus negative 1. So this will be, this is going to be equal to 2. 2 times 32 is 64 over 15. And that's it for this example.